in the way. Come on and help me give reverence to this awesome man and woman of God that is the shepherds over this house. Come on, put your hands together. Jesus. Pastor and co-pastor Barnes. I call them mama and daddy. Amen. Awesome man and woman of God. It's standing tall in the gospel. So we know they don't need no preaching over here because both of them can preach. Amen. And don't stop there. Give it up for yourselves. To all of the evangelists and prophets, ministers, to my friends, my sisters in Christ, amen. I got some sisters, they don't play when it comes to their little sister, amen. They show up in the time of need, amen, and I thank God for them, amen. My sisters is in the building, amen. They know they didn't come to look cute, but they came to help. Amen. Awesome women of God. Amen. I am so grateful. I am so honored to be able to step behind this sacred desk for the third year in a row. Amen. God is so awesome. He's so faithful. Amen. It's something about you when people call you back. Amen. And it's such an honor to come over here and be in the presence of my family, amen, to see an awesome job. You all look around there doing an awesome job in this ministry, amen. Yes. Every time I come over, it's something new, amen. Let me know that God is not just blessing on the west side, but he's doing the same thing, amen, out south. Listen, before we go any further, I need a shift. Anybody know that when the Spirit of the Lord falls, there needs to be a certain sound. Amen. I'm not talking about crying. I'm talking about a sound that let me know that Daddy is here. Amen. Dancers, get ready. I need you. I need you real quick. Royal, if you can just let your power fall one time. Just what I would appreciate it so much. I feel it in my spirit. And listen to me. It's a blessing when folk tell their testimony. Because you never know who it is that you're blessing. As my sister stood here, she's older than me, she's my big sister. She stood here to tell her testimony. I just spoke that same thing in one of my spiritual daughters' life. And I told her, I said, baby, you got to pray over your own self.
That's right.
Yeah. You got to pray over your womb because God is a God that will not lie. He said that his word will not return to him void. And when you pray over your own self, you got to believe. And the reason I know it's not because my big sister stood here and told it, but it's because I've seen his work. I sat in the same doctor's office when they told me that it was impossible. They told me that the baby days was over. But I did not understand because God had already showed me my son. And I was not going to take what the doctor said according to what God was saying. So I denounced him and went to praying over my own self. And I tell you right now today, that baby that they said would never make it, that would never be conceived. He's 1 year old. It's over. And I'm not just talking about birthing a baby. I'm talking about some of you all that got something down in your spirit that the enemy said that it wouldn't come forth. But the devil is a liar. Today is your birthday. I'm looking at your neck and say, you're going to give it today.
Come on. Jesus. But the devil is a lie. It got to come out. It got to be released. The spirit is saying, today is your day. It's bursting out. I feel a push. I feel a push.
Your past. He's not concerned with who you connected to. What he's concerned with is where
because daddy sees all. He's not concerned with your itty-bitty motion. He's not concerned with how many dances you can do. But what he's concerned with is your spirit. And Esther had a good spirit. And even though she was sacrificing the Jews, her own life, her parent that raised her, Mordecai, she knew that if it didn't follow the right way, that they would die. But how many of you all here today and said, I don't care what it looks like. I'm not looking no more in the natural. I'm getting ready to put my spiritual glasses on, because my God said that he's for me and that he's for me. He's more than the world against me. Bring it on, Satan. Bring it on, Satan. I'm not scared of you.
Yeah.
right now as I speak. The Spirit of the Lord said, no more tricks. No more mind games. He said, you're stronger than what you think. He said, the reason he knows is because he created you from your mother's womb. That's why you were ordained for such a time as this. He said, you probably don't understand because you look at it and say, God, I don't know. He said, but you know. And even as a little girl, you spoke it out of your own mouth. You seen it. He said, and that you say, now he needs you to do. He said, you can no longer be a hearer, but you got to be a doer. He said, speak over it and watch and see the salvation. The Bible says, ye not need to fight. He said, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. The battle is not yours. It's the Lord's. And you belong.
Yeah.
This is my queen. And I just encourage you today that I don't care what you're going through. That you get down on your knees and you begin to look up in the spirit and watch that and look back at you and say, everybody in here with the activities of their knees to get down.